Well, it's not just the general public who don't really understand it. The scientists who have produced it have absolutely no idea of the mathematics of the waveform that it's going to produce or that it is producing. We know that it is in the, generally it's in the gigahertz range. Now I'll explain that. But the problems are, is that first there are, like its predecessors, there are no safety checks at all carried out on 5G. There are no safety tests at all carried out on anything to do with 5G. It is known that the gigahertz range, in other words, the waveform, the waves that come out, it is known that they are in the same frequency as some of our cellular processes in our body, some of our cells. It is known they can interfere with the cellular processes of the body. There are several different waveforms for 5G. It isn't just one wave. Already, I do know that 40 leading groups, or 40 leading groups of scientists in 40 countries, leading scientists in 40 countries have warned that the waveforms from 5G can be particularly harmful, not just to humans, but to all living species. And I can tell you as a military man that one of the top waveforms for 5G is incredibly close. And in terms of electronic waveforms, there really isn't much difference from the new microwave weapon called active denial that is now in use for crowd control to subdue and bring down crowds. And that is known or reputed to cause visual disturbances, certainly neurological disturbances, heart disturbances, all sorts of things. Now, that is the new active denial, which can be also released from aircraft or beamed from aircraft, that is incredibly close to one of the frequencies on 5G. And as I said, there are no, the waveform is so mathematically complex that nobody can really tell you how it's going to react, other than it makes a damn good weapon. And we are now producing this and handing it to toddlers.
And you said to me, or I'll never forget it, you said, Richie, as it stands, you said, low-level wireless radio frequency, that's low-level wireless radio frequency. This is back now 6-7 years ago. When we're exposed to that, it can disrupt cell metabolism. It can reduce melatonin, which, of course, controls your sleeping and your waking cycles.
And your immune system.
And your immune system.
And your immune system, yeah.
And you said it'll disrupt brain glucose metabolism and it'll mess around with the blood-brain barrier. That was low-level wireless radio frequency. And you were proven to be right. So this is something different entirely, Barrie, for the layperson. What's it like? Is it like turning 4G up to, you know, from 7 up to 1,000 on the dial on the radio? What is it?
I suppose the simple answer, of course, is yes and no. Each particular frequency can affect different parts of the body. You have, in an adult body, you have around 4,500 biological structures. And every part of your body, every single part of your body is in communication with every other part. Every single cell in your body produces its own electric and magnetic field. and they all, it's like a constant chatter that goes on in your body all the time. But they all have their own different resonant, cyclotronic, and circadian frequencies. Now, when I was talking to spies and studying this during the Cold War, it was realized that different frequencies could cause different things to happen in the body. There's a frequency that can cause the bowel to collapse, the eyes to go funny, the heart to collapse, and so on. And there are 4,500 different structures in the body that can be known to be affected. So as you run through the 2G, 3G, 4G, then you can affect different ones. When I was talking to spies, and my list, the list that I made, I suppose I had a list, an active list of networks then that used between 40 and 60 different frequencies that could cause up to around 100 neurological and physiological conditions. The latest list that I have, I've seen one of 600. The latest list I've seen or heard of is now 750 different frequencies that can cause neurological, physiological harm. But it isn't 750 where you get this one or this one or this one. Mathematically, it is 750 factorial, which means you can get the effects of one multiplied by two, multiplied by three, up to 750. Now, 5G is going to encompass a lot of what all of the other Gs have and introduce its own as well. And this is why the top scientists in 40 countries have actually signed a petition saying, you know, you cannot do this. But like all of the other Gs, the industry and the government scientists are choosing to ignore the entire scientific body throughout the world and just plod on regardless, because they are actually above the law. You know, they can buy the law. The industry, I had a symposium here not too many months ago with, there were 11 professors and research doctors here for 4 days discussing all of this and turning it into a DVD. And they were just absolutely horrified that nobody is being listened to. And the producer of this, he said, well, I've researched this industry and it is now estimated at $17
trillion. $17 trillion.
$17 trillion. And when you have that much money, you know, you can buy governments, you can buy countries, and it's not difficult to buy scientists. It really isn't. That will do an experiment which is legitimate but not accurate, and it will cause confusion. And this is what they're doing, and they're going to get away with it. Because they are above the law.
Can I ask you this, Barrie? Let me ask you this. Again, going back to when we first began talking, we talked about the effects of radiation on the smallest creatures in the world. Well, not the smallest creatures, but, you know, the smallest creatures that we come into contact with every day. Birds, of course, and bees and insects.
Yeah.
Are we going to see... You know, because we talked about how back in the early 2000s, we saw incidences of birds falling out of the sky, birds abandoning their nests, all sorts of issues that we saw back then. Are these issues, are we going to see more of this in the next 2 to 3 to 4 years?
It's going to get worse. In my paper, which I wrote 3 years ago now, Wi-Fi thalidomide in the making, I predicted for the human race that, and David Icke picked this up and published it, I proved using government figures, World Health Organization figures, secret figures, I proved that in just 3 generations, 60 years of human life, only Of the exposed populations, only 1 in 8 children after 3 generations could be born healthy. Now, that has been, people picked that up and ran with experiments, which I'm very pleased of. And I read just a few days ago that experiments show that entire species can be extinct in 5 generations. Now, that would match my prediction, because if you've got only 1 in 8 roughly after 3, you then don't have enough population of anything to sustain a workable population. So it's been published, I read it just a few days ago, that they are now showing that after 5 generations for some animals, they could become extinct, except, and this is interesting, except bacteria and viruses. They seem to proliferate and grow and become more deadly in microwaves.
So while it's destroying, while it's destroying the biological makeup of creatures, of mammals, of yeah. you know, marsupials, of human beings, it actually increases the potency of viruses and some bacteria. That's extraordinary.
Oh, yeah, and it was because this came up in our conversation.
Yeah.
And I can tell you, he wouldn't mind me, he's published it. It was Professor Moskala, who is the senior professor of Vienna University. I mentioned this, and he said, oh, yes, and he came out with the proteins on the bacterium and that. But it's known, and it is published, that bacterium, when they're exposed to microwaves, they can reproduce so rapidly that they have a defensive mechanism. Well, of course, they are the oldest living beings on the planet. They've developed a defensive mechanism, and they reproduce more rapidly, and they become immune to antibiotics. They sort of turn into sort of a super bacterium.
There's a couple of quotes I want to just read out here from learned men and women. This is Olga Sheehan. She's a former employee of the World Health Organization, and she wrote a book called No Safe Place. You might be aware of Olga, Barrie. Olga says, Olga says, the plans to beam highly penetrative 5G millimeter-wave radiation at us from space must surely be one of the greatest follies ever conceived of by mankind. There will be nowhere safe to live. And as well as not hearing Barrie Trower on BBC television or radio, we don't hear people like Olga Sheehan. That's, you know, everybody in the world should hear that, whether they want to dismiss it out of hand or whether they want to investigate it. The greatest follies ever conceived of by mankind, there will be nowhere safe to live, Barrie.
With these microwaves, and it is known, there are 20, 30,000 research papers. With microwaves, we do know that every living thing on the planet, except bacterium and virus, every living thing, trees, everything, plants, every single thing, birds, fish, everything is affected by microwaves. Now, with us, when they're beaming these down from satellites, you have nowhere to go.
Nowhere.
You have absolutely nowhere to go. But you do have a choice at the moment not to be vaccinated. You have a choice not to eat certain foods. There is a little choice that you can have. It may be living away from the general population, which some people would quite like, but you have a choice not to do those. There is no choice with microwaves.